My pleasure to introduce you today on Seriously Speaking, Kemi Adetiba.
Yay. Yeah.
So you have to catwalk. Okay, okay, okay. There you are. Where did those legs come from? Hi, love. Nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Right. Nice to meet you on camera.
On camera.
And on this side.
Kemi Adetiba is one of the most prominent filmmakers in the Nigerian entertainment industry. She is popularly known for movies like The Wedding Party, King of Boys, and a host of memorable music videos. Kemi Adetiba loves music. She grew up around it. Her love for music stems from her younger days when she watched her dad play music on vinyl players.
Always music playing, vinyl, you know, like the vinyls, the old school, like the vinyl records. And my dad used to have this tradition of he'll take out the vinyl from the cover and then he'll spin it around and then use his bottom to clean it, you know, and then before he keys it in. So it was a very musical family. We're pretty close.
One of her most unique qualities as a filmmaker is her ability to send messages to the viewer of her movies through music. This video seeks to take a closer look at how Kemi Adetiba utilizes music as a tool, character, and plot-driving device in her movies. Here is a deeper dive into the mind of Kemi Adetiba, music and movie connoisseur. But first, a bit of backstory. Kemi Adetiba's career in entertainment didn't start from movies. She started out as an on-air personality for Rhythm 93.7 FM, where she anchored shows like Sold Out and Sundays at the Seaside. Her time at the radio station helped her smooth transition into the music industry. After much success, she decided to explore the movie world, attending the New York Film Academy. Then she took her first baby steps by directing a few music videos until she eventually made her debut in 2009 with Across a Bloodied Ocean, a short film which was screened at the Pan African Film Festival. This obviously gave her a boost as she went on to write and direct The Wedding Party in 2016. Then 3 years later, she proceeded to make the record-breaking box office hit, King of Boys, in 2019. Even though she doesn't make lots of them, Kemi Adetiba's music videos have a distinct style.
Even my music videos, I try to cram in little movies into them.
There is a cinematic element to them. They usually contain an engaging storyline, colorful characters, vibrant cinematography, and a dramatic plot twist, which makes a few works in the music industry stay in your mind as a viewer. Her ability to mix cinema and music also show in her movies. And she likes to show off the Nigerian tradition of socializing by inserting lengthy party scenes with characters dancing along to trendy pop music. Adetiba's working experience with musicians also show in her movies. It's not a coincidence that most of her memorable characters are played by popular musicians, most of whom have never been in a movie before. Perhaps the most notable way she utilizes the element of music into her movies is in the movie soundtracks. Each movie has a structured playlist of its own, and each main character has their own theme music. This is a big deal as most Nigerian movies don't even consider this. Using The Wedding Party as a case study, there was a scene earlier in the movie when characters started a scene by singing and their vocals blended into the background music. This was clearly a calculated and rehearsed move, not something that was added in post-production as an afterthought. The families of the protagonists also have differing background music, almost on polar opposite sides. The Yoruba family, oozing with affluence and riches, had a typical Afrobeat in the background, while the Igbo family, who seemed more inclined to the Western world, had a symphony playing in the background.
Surely they could have found a better picture to publish.
A couple of scenes after that, the wedding coordinator had a beat that played out hyper-dramatically, like a drill sergeant marking off attendance in a roll call in boot camp.
Waiters!
Yes, ma'am.
Drink and refreshments! Food and consumption! Food and consumption! Food and...
The cinematography, character blocking, and most especially the background music heightens the drama intensity. Later in the scene, our arch rival, the wedding coordinator from the other family, bursts into the scene to the tune of an energetic Afrobeat instrumental.
Who are you? I am Bonuola Arawale Cole, acting activations director at Events Expert.
Hold this one.
Characters busting into a scene is a technique Adetiba loves to use a lot. It's also the way she introduces Rosie, an ex-lover of Dozie, the protagonist of the movie who was getting married. Rosie is immediately shown as an agent of disruption. Her music, a dominant boom-bap type of beat, interrupts the harmonious symphony being played by the protagonist's father in the Igbo family. After the wedding scene, the wedding montage was extensive and accompanied by a beautiful song by Banky W, an already established Nigerian musician making his acting debut as this movie's protagonist. But no other example showed how much Kemi Adetiba fuses music with her movies, other than the dance battle scene at the wedding reception. This was undoubtedly one of the most memorable scenes in the movie. It was a typical example of Adetiba using music to elevate regular incidents into dramatic moments. Each family danced into the party to their own specific opposing genres of music, with the intention of outshining each other. And by extension, this turned what was supposed to be an entrance dance sequence into a dance battle. The bride's family even going as far as hyping one another with a rhythmic chant before busting on scene to a fast-paced Afrobeat track.
Hey! 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 Hey!
In King of Boys, Kemi blends the musical experience into a movie with social events and celebration scenes. The first 8 minutes of the movie is basically a party, with some of the main characters getting introduced to us while fast bubbly music acted as a backdrop. Characters having their theme music not only makes the characters stand out, it also subconsciously registers their place in your mind for a long time after you see the movie. Adetiba employs one of the oldest tricks in the book. By marking the main character's most significant moments with their theme music, she punctuates the dramatic stakes and consistently turns up the intensity all through the movie.
I hate when people waste my time. Clear the mess.
You're taking him too lightly and it makes us look weak and afraid.
Weak? Ye yo teku. Keshebi todo.
And you also taught me. Agboto fenyimilo. Agbara lolomua.
Kemi. Warike.
Bad table.
In front of everybody here today, I and Nola Salami will stretch our hands over your dead body.
Makaraki, the step. Makaraki, don't call me.
Adetiba is very intentional with her usage of music as a core foundation of her films. Her experience in music prior to movies works to her advantage, and sets her apart from her peers. She may not have many movies yet, but she has set a high benchmark to beat with her movies. Aside from being a big fan of her works, I have genuine faith in her skills being a core catalyst regarding the progress of the Nigerian movie industry. Here is to you, Kemi, the King Woman. More power to you, and may you live long and prosper.